The clearer your instructions are to your subconscious, the more it can help you. This inner mind responds to your commands much the way sailors manning the engine and controls of an ocean liner respond to the orders of the captain on deck. If the words are precise and unmistakable, then the crew sets about turning the vessel to the order direction or increasing its speed exactly as they are told. But if you as a captain are not sure yourself what you want, then your subconscious mind will get an unclear message and your ship will follow a random or haphazard or circular course. You need to tell your subconscious exactly what you want. You need to direct it to help attain your goals. When you know what your true desire really is, your subconscious mind will propel you unerringly toward it. But it needs to know that you genuinely, fervently, and unwaveringly want this goal, and that you will not forsake it for all the other conflicting and contradictory wishes, notions, and momentary fancies that flit through your mind. In that way, you become a positive thinker and are set to meet your goals. And comes, believe in your goals and you will achieve them. Prosperity begins in the mind and is impossible to achieve while the mental attitude is hostile to it. It is fatal to work for one thing and to expect something else, because everything must be created mentally first and is bound to follow its mental pattern. You cannot become prosperous if you really expect or half expect to remain poor. We tend to get what we expect, and to expect nothing is to get nothing. When every step you take is on the road to failure, how can you hope to arrive at the success goal? Facing the wrong way towards the black, depressing, hopeless outlook, even though we may be working in the opposite direction, kills the result of our effort. Thoughts and magnets that attract things like themselves. If your mind dwells upon poverty and disease, it will bring you poverty and disease. There are no possibility of your producing just the opposite of what you are holding in your mind, because your mental attitude is the pattern which is built on into your life. Your accomplishments are achieved mentally first. The terror of failure and fear of coming to want and of possible humiliation keep multitudes of people from obtaining the very things they desire by sapping their vitality and incapacitating them through worry and anxiety for the effective creative work necessary to give them success. Be an optimist. Develop the habit of looking at everything constructively from the bright, hopeful side, the side of faith and assurance. Refrain from looking at life with doubt and uncertainty. Acquire the habit of believing the best is going to happen, that the right must triumph. Have faith that truth is bound finally to conquer error, that harmony and health are the reality, and discord and disease, the temporary absence of it. This is the attitude of the optimist which will ultimately reform the world. Analyze yourself. There is only one person in the entire world who can set you on the road to success. That person is you. Before you can determine what goals can get you started on this journey, you must first evaluate yourself. Search deep inside of your mind and pull out from your consciousness what it is you really want out of life, and what assets you have that will lead you to reaching that goal. You must be realistic. You may want to establish a goal that appears desirable, but you may not have the abilities needed to achieve it. You may want to be a movie star or an opera singer, but don't have the talent needed. Your dream career may be in areas that are not feasible for you to attempt. On the other hand, you may have aptitudes and skills that you don't realize you have, and which can lead to a satisfying and profitable career. How can you find out? Look deeply inside yourself. A careful introspection will bring this out. Most adults already know what they can and cannot do, what they like and do not like. It may not be obvious, but introspection enables you to go beyond an obvious and think deeply about yourself. A good example of this is Shonda Rhimes, creator and executive producer of the television shows Grey's Anatomy and Private Practice. Even as a child, she knew that she would become a creative writer. She made up stories and spoke them into a tape recorder before she knew how to write. Her mother encouraged her by transcribing them, hence making them real. What you have to do is go systematically over your education, previous experience, hobbies, and interests. Look for those aspects of your life in which you have been successful and in which you achieved satisfaction and joy. These are indicators of the areas in which you will succeed in the future. But this is only the beginning. Successful people learn at very outset of their careers just what funds they can draw upon. Take an inventory of all your possible assets and resources. Don't just look at what you have accomplished thus far in your life, but what you know you can accomplish. The great majority of young people start on their career with little knowledge of their mental capacities, and they usually discover them piece by piece over time. Most people never discover more than a small percent of their ability and never rise above low-paid, low-level positions. They plod along in mediocrity, yet they have resources. If they could only detect them, it could lift them into superior positions. Somehow, they never come in touch with the right sort of ambition, arousing environment, or do not come in contact with just the necessary material to ignite the giant power of the great within of themselves. One way to identify your hidden potential is to list those aspects of your schooling, jobs held, and other activities in which you have been engaged. Then reflect on which of these activities you enjoy doing most, which gave you the most satisfaction, and those you really disliked performing. Josh D, a 25-year-old college grad, had been very unhappy in his job as a claims adjuster in an insurance company. He had majored in business management and had taken this job with the hope it would lead to a management position. When he listed all the types of activities he performed, he realized that what he liked least was doing detail work. He noted that his boss and his boss's boss spent most of their time in similar activities. He also noted that the aspect of this job that he enjoyed most was dealing with the policyholders, interviewing them, and working with them on their claims. in reviving his school activities and his work with a community group, he found that his most rewarding work had been with people. Josh discussed this with the human resource department of his company, and they suggested he might find his niche and be more successful in a sales position. He made the change and now is enjoying his work and is on the road to a successful career. Oneness of purpose. Successful people strongly believe that one must be totally committed to one's goals. There is a great power in a resolution that has no reservation in it, a strong, persistent, tenacious purpose that burns all bridges behind it, clears all obstacles from its path, and arrives at its goal, no matter how long it may take, no matter what the sacrifice or the cost. To succeed, you must concentrate all the faculties of your mind upon one unwavering aim and have tenacity of purpose, which means death or victory. Every other inclination that tempts you must be suppressed. One talent person who decides upon a definite object accomplishes more than a 10 talent person who scatters energies and never know exactly what to do. By concentrating powers upon one thing, the weakest living creature can accomplish something. By dispersing powers over many things, the strongest may fail to accomplish anything. A thimbleful of powder behind a ball in a rifle will do more for execution than a carload of powder unconfined. The rifle barrel is the purpose that gives aim to the powder, which otherwise, no matter how good it might be, would be powerless. It is the single aim that wins. People who succeed have a program. They plan a course and adhere to it. They lay out their plans and execute them. They go straight to their goal. They are not pushed this way and that way every time a difficulty is thrown in their path. If they can't go over it, they go through it. Constant and steady use of faculties under a central purpose gives strength and power, while the use of faculties without an aim or end only weakens them. The mind must be focused on a definite end, or like machinery without a balance wheel, it will wreck itself to pieces. Sum and substance. Developing goals that are reasonable and achievable is the first step to success, whether it is in your career or any other aspect of your life. You must plant the seeds in your subconscious mind that will enable you to accept and implement these goals. Here are 7 steps that will facilitate this process. These steps we will discuss in next video.